Hello students, welcome to Vidya Mirad. I am going to teach you today parallel lines and its transversal properties in lines and angles for class 9th, which is my second video on this. These are the questions which I am expecting you to do, where you need to find out the values of the variables or the angles required. Please do this after watching the whole video, and if you face any problem, let me know. Let's begin. If you see over here, M and N, they are parallel to one another, and your line which is crossing or intersecting that L, that is known as the transversal. There are so many angles formed in this. So let us discuss one by one what are these angles called. Number one, we will talk about the corresponding angles. So let's see what are corresponding angles. It means if you look here, your angle 1 is equal to angle 5. That means if I take angle 1 as 60 degrees, then your 1 and 5, that will be 60 degrees. Okay. Same way, angle 2 will be equal to angle 6, angle 4 will be equal to angle 8, and angle 3 will be equal to angle 7. You need to remember this. Whenever we are going to solve these type of questions, we will mention why they are equal. Suppose I am writing angle 4 is equal to angle 8. Okay, so in bracket I will mention it is because they are the corresponding angles formed. So like that way, I need to remember which angle is equal to which angle and what is the reason behind that. Number 2. Alternate interior angles, or we also call as alternate angles. If you see, your angle 4 is equal to angle 6. If you see the cross, red cross, okay, that are the interior. 4 is equal to 6 and 3 is equal to 5. These are the interior. Same way, your exterior angles are also equal. If you look here, your 2 is equal to 8 and your 1 is equal to 7. You can see the yellow cross. So your red cross was there to identify your interior, and your yellow cross is telling you about the exterior angles. Same way, if you have interior angles on the same side of the transversal, that is angle 4 or angle 5, and angle 3 and angle 6, their sum will be equal to 180 degrees. And we are going to apply this in various other questions. Let us do some questions. See, now here you are given that angle 2 is equal to 120 and angle 5 is equal to 60. So I have marked it over here so that it becomes easy. We need to prove that M is parallel to N. How we are going to prove? Let us see. If I take the case angle 5 and angle 6, it sits on the straight line. So that means their sum should be equal to 180 degrees because of the linear pair property. And angle 5 I already know. So angle 6 is 120 degrees. Now if you see, angle 2 is 120 and angle 6 is also 120. So what is it looking like? These are corresponding angles. When 2 is equal to 6, that means your M is parallel to N. Next question. Again I have taken the same figure. But here now it is given that your angles 1 and 2, they are in the ratio of 3 is to 2. Now 1 and 2, they are forming a linear pair. Okay. And their sum is equal to 180 degrees. So what I will do is, I can find out X very easily. When I know X, so I know their angles also, that angle 1 is equal to 108 and angle 2 is equal to 72 degrees. Now if I want to know the other angles, now see, I have mentioned here angle 3 is equal to angle 1, or if you know angle 1, you know angle 2. If 1 will be equal to 3 and 2 will be equal to 4 because of the vertical and opposite angles. Now when I know 3 and 4, I know I can use alternate angles. 3 will be equal to 5 and 4 will be equal to 6 because of the alternate interior angles, or angle 1 will be equal to angle 5 and angle 2 will be equal to angle 6 because of corresponding angles. So I can use any method to solve it. Now here I have mentioned corresponding angles. You can also use alternate angles. Same way, when I know 5 and 6, I can simply again apply vertically opposite angle. 5 will be equal to 7 and 6 will be equal to 8 because of the vertically opposite angles. Now if you see here, because we know the two angles, we are able to find out all other angles with the help of them and with the help of various properties. Now children, it is not necessary that you need to follow these only. There can be other ways, like just now I have told the alternate interior angles, even alternate exterior angles. Your angle 1 will be equal to angle 7, okay? Your 2 will be equal to angle 8 because of the exterior alternate angles. Just now we have done the previous. So any method, you can choose any method to find out the angles whatsoever it is convenient. Just follow the slide 1. You should know what are corresponding angles. You should know alternate interior angle. You should know alternate exterior angles thoroughly. Okay. Next example. Now see, it's a figure given over here. We need to prove in this figure that AB is parallel to EF. Okay. Let's begin with it. We have all the values given with us. Now if you look here, angle ABC, it is 65 degrees, and if you look at BCD, your BCD is a combination of 30 plus 35, which is again 65. So that means your AB, angle B and angle C, they both are equal 65 degrees. So we can say that AB is parallel to CD as they are forming alternate angles. Same way if you look, angle FEC and angle CECD, 145 degrees plus 35 degrees, that gives you 180 degrees. Your EF is parallel to CD in that case. Okay, sum of the angles formed on the same side of transversal is 180 degrees. So therefore, we can say that EF is parallel to CD. So from equation 1 and 2, CD is common in both the cases. We can say that AB is parallel to EF. See children, here both way the question can come. Either they will give you parallel line and they will be asked to find out the angle, or they will give you the angles and they will ask you to correlate it and find out whether there are parallel lines or not. Now in this case question, we are given all the angles. Because of these angles, we should know which property to apply. And because of the property, I can prove that lines are parallel to one another. Next example. Here I have angle 1 given as 60 degrees and angle 2 is 2/3 of a right angle. And I need to prove that M is parallel to N. So how I am going to do? See, angle 1 is 60 degrees, which means now angle they have given angle 2. Angle 2 is 2/3 of a right angle, which means angle 2 is also equal to 60 degrees. And what is about 3 and 2? If you see, they are vertically opposite angles. So angle 3 is equal to angle 2. But we can also say that angle 1 is equal to angle 3 because of the corresponding angles we have just proved earlier. So which proves that your lines M and N are parallel to one another. Let's do one more question. See the figure. Here we have to find out the value of x. The dotted lines is done for the construction to make your question easy. So I have mentioned as angle 1 and angle 2 separately. We will calculate it and find out the answer. Now if you look here, I have done AB parallel to EO and they are parallel to PO is your transversal. When PO is your transversal, I can apply the property of that angles on the same side of transversal, their sum is 180. We know one angle 45 degrees, so we can find out angle 1 easily. which states that angle 1 comes to 135 degrees. If you think 135 plus 45, that comes to 180 angles on the same side of transversal. Same way, I can find out angle 2, that comes to 150. What is 150 plus 30? 180. Both the ways, if you see, I know what is angle 1, I know what is angle 2. You can combine together and you can come to know that x is equal to 285. I can even cross check my answer. See, if you see angle 1 and 2, and if you see on the right hand side, it will form a circle. Your angles of the circle should be 360 degrees. Okay. So what I know 1, I know 2. What will be on the O side, if you see, it will, one angle will be 45, other angle will be 30 degrees because of the alternate angles. There is a center line, parallel line. So I can use that thing in my mind and take out the sum of all the angles, that comes to 360 degrees, which means my angle 1 and 2 is correct. Now see, very nice question. Here you are given that PS is parallel to PO. Okay, you need to find out X. Now what I need to do is, I did the construction such that TU is a line which is parallel to OP and RS. So if TU is a line, there is an angle 1 formed in it. So there is one X and there is angle 1 I have mentioned here. So let's do it. If I take RS and QU as a parallel line and you take RQ as a transversal, angles on the same side of transversal, their sum is equal to 180 degrees. So you have 130 degrees, you have angle 1, you can easily find out angle 1 in that case. So what will be angle 1? Angle 1 will be 50 degrees. Okay. Now, if you consider OP and TU as a parallel line and PQ as a transversal, it means that angle OPQ will be equal to angle PQU. Why? They are alternate angles. So I can find out X in that case. So X comes to 60 degrees. So what is 60 plus 50? 110. So that means I had to find out angle X, that is 60 degrees, as per the properties of alternate angles and angles on the same side of transversal. I hope, children, you have understood. We have done plenty of questions on the parallel lines and transversal. Please follow this thoroughly. You should know all the angles. You need to practice, draw number of times and try to name it yourself differently and find out what are corresponding angles, what are interior angles, what are exterior angles, so that you are able to apply during the question easily. Thank you very much, children, for watching the video till the end. And in the next video, I am going to teach you the angle sum property, as well as there will be certain question on exterior angle property, which is very important. Please do see that video thoroughly.